Hello, welcome to what I hope is going to be the first let's play of this game here, Dominus Galaxia. It is in closed alpha, so it is not fully functional, but a lot of it is already working. And I will start a new game. On the standard square shaped galaxy, you can see you have a few more to choose, but I'm going for square right now. 100 stars is also okay. Game mode, I will be picking deathmatch because normal was just recently added and contains diplomacy, but diplomacy does not properly work yet. Opponents, I will keep it at average. There's also a problem with map generation, so it doesn't work as you'd like to anyways. So difficulty, there's dynamic levels, but I'm not going to use these adapt during play, and this is something I don't personally like. I'm going for the static ones, and here we have quite a lot of levels, and I will be picking the one in the middle, which is the master level. And master means the AI plays at its best. On the lower levels, the AI plays worse. But it doesn't have any advantages on these levels. They do have advantages, but I don't think they need it because they are pretty good without. I will be playing the humans. There's two playable races right now. The other races are just AI controlled. The reason is the graphics are not done for all of them yet, so this is something to be added. And I will be using my normal nickname and the color teal, I guess. Yeah, they have lower maintenance cost for their military. The other race I could pick is the spider race, but I want to pick the slightly weaker one, and the name got changed back. This is maybe something that should be changed, that when you have entered your ruler name and switch between the races, that it doesn't change. Okay, I will get into the game. Don't want to bore you with the menu. Loading screen. About the deploy. I don't know if it's recording right now because I know that I'm using. Okay, the game is starting. The starting location looks relatively good, I have to say. There's quite a few stars in the immediate range. And I will be sending out my fighters for scouting. As you can see, I can use waypoints, and I will use it like that. This is not the quickest way. Oops. No. This is a bit unfortunate. I have to deselect because movement is done with the left key. It's something you have to get used to right now. I think it is planned to be configurable, but right now it's done with the left key and not like in most other games with the right key. Okay, there's not anything else to do. This should not be visible here in deathmatch mode because it doesn't work anyways, and that's in normal mode it kinda works, but there's a few bugs like AI sending a non-aggression pact request every turn, which is quite annoying, and it worked before. I don't know why it was why it doesn't anymore. Okay, how many? Oh, I should probably explain a bit more because all the things that I'm doing here are so natural for me because I've played this game so often. So you do not build colony ships in this game. Once you have scouted a world, you can click the colonize button right next to it, and then you can send population. As you see, the population goes up that is sent there and is going down at the home world. I don't want to send too many people to this system because I'm probably not going to build a starport here. Starport is required to build ships and send population, and unless you have one, you cannot do this from this world. It also extends your range, What you see here is the starport range for this home planet here, Sol. And since this is pretty small, I want to see what other colonizable worlds I have in my area before I decide where to send the most population. This one is uninhabitable, so no population is going there. Okay, ship is already moving to the next system. Let's see what this is. This one also is not colonizable, but a tundra. Tundra is colonizable earlier. Then toxic, and this one is also really bad. It has only a maximum population of 8. Even if it was colonizable, it wouldn't be too useful. 27 is also not that great. And 45 also not that great. There's good planets are usually from, I'd say, 65 to they go well over 100 sometimes. I've seen planets as big as 140 or even 150 sometimes, but they are pretty rare. The good ones are pretty rare. By the way, this here is a stealth nebula. It's called radioactive nebula here and not stealth. And it means that I cannot see into this direction. So only when ships are coming from this general direction, I will not be able to see them unless they leave the nebula here. Maybe one turn without warning. But currently there's no systems visible. And in, but this planet is a good one. Okay, I will send a bit more population to this one. Well, I will be sending more later maybe, because I first want to know what's over there. And I don't want to commit. Okay, this one is also colonizable, so I'll be sending a few population over there like that. I don't want to drop too low on my homeworld, because the population growth depends on the amount of people there. Also, the factories, once I have less than twice as many factories, when I have more than twice the factories as I have population, then it will be relatively inefficient. I think only 10% of the efficiency, but it can be increased with technology. Okay, I've colonized the system. It actually didn't add more visible planets than this one, which I already could see from here. So I'm still waiting which planet I'm committing to sending my highest amount of population. Okay, this one has two systems nearby. So I will be rushing a starport, and I have this button here. When I click it, you can see this adds some from my reserve. I'm getting 10% of my populations as taxes, which also can be increased by research. And I will be using it here. 3.9 BC per turn will be invested into the improvement of the system. The capacity cannot access the double the amount of the normal output, and the normal output is 3.9, so it's doubled to 7.8. And I'm saving a little bit per turn. Actually, I'm saving more than I can spend on the system, but this will change once I send more population over there, which is what I'm going to do now. I will balance these out so that both are at 30%. This should be the best option for growth, but I'm not 100% sure it really is. I also want to be getting a... One moment, I have actually overbuilt on factories, so I have more factories that can be operated by the population, so I will be now changing this up here. And also invest in research on all the other planets. It's automatically, when you colonize, it's automatically put on factories. And I should really explain a bit more to the people that haven't played this game, or Mass of Orion 1 for that matter, because it is very similar in how it works. there are some changes, so okay. But I want to get the starport here first. Once this one is finished, I might be getting another one, and I will now be able to pick research projects. You can see the scientists, they are doing research, typing in a computer and looking through a window and stuff. Okay, this is quite unfortunate. I do not have the +10 terraforming and barren colonization. I haven't found a barren planet yet. I have only seen a tundra one, and tundra is higher than barren, so barren isn't useful for me. But improved ecological restoration is a good technology because it reduces my waste, actually, or the amount of BC I have to spend on waste. I will show what I mean. Okay, we have quite a few computer projects. I've actually never seen that many to be picked on the first pick. I think I will be getting the scanner range. Or no, I will be getting the targeting system too. Factory construction is relatively no-brainer, I'd say. This one here increases the unmanned factory production rate to 20%, but I'm not planning to have too many unmanned factories. This is it's a bit of micromanagement to prevent that. And here I have the choice of getting class 1 or class 2 shield. The difference is class 1 shield is much cheaper, and it also will unlock the next tier, which is the technologies from level 5 to 10, no, from 6 to 10 actually, but it is not of too much use, so I will be getting class 2 shields. Logistics range 1 is much more important than nuclear engines. This was changed originally. We had 1 parsec per turn for the normal engines, but all engines were buffed to give 1 more speed, so the importance of them is not that great anymore, and I will be getting logistics range 1. And for the weapons, well, most of them, this one here, as you can see, it's not implemented, so I will obviously not research it. Gatling lasers, not really that great, so it's only between those two. And I really don't want to be caught off guard with really bad ground troops with no weapons at all, because they will just die to anyone who has weapons, so I'll be getting laser rifle. And I can also change the allocation, but it's not immediate, but I will still increase the propulsion research first. I don't want to reduce all the others to nothing, because it slowly adapts to this level here, and I'm losing a bit of research whenever I change this. This is made to prevent making this micromanagement sure, and just to concentrate for longer amount of time, and I am planning to concentrate on propulsion for quite some time. I think for at least until I run into another civ, no, faction is the right word in this game, I suppose. Okay, so I'm clicking a bit through now. There's not too much to do after the initial colonization. I need my starport to finish. I need to get new technologies. And I might want to redistribute population a bit to increase growth. For example, I can make sure that this system stays at around 50%. And try to get the others up to 50% as well. Have a look at, okay, we can currently support, it's a bit of a mass problem here. It's maybe there should be some indication in the interface. I will actually reduce the factory production even more, as we currently still are below what we can support. And I will be sending a bit more population even. Okay, this is the last transport I'm sending to this planet. this planet already is above 50%, so no use to send more population to them. Okay. And I will also be starting to get a starport over here. I will not be boosting it right now, because I don't want... Now it's only, as you can see, we don't have the funds anymore. There's now only 16.7 BC per turn that can be used from our overall taxing, because the basic productivity of this plant increased, and I can now scout these two systems. And I will stop this, and instead I will apply the stimulus over here. This one is also a good planet. I'll be getting it immediately. Let's see. Yeah, let's send that much population there. Maybe even a bit from here. Yeah, let's do it like this. I can send from several systems at once, as you can see. And I finished my first research project, the class 2 deflector shields, and I will be now getting personal deflector shields. As I said, I really don't want to have bad ground combat. Ground combat can, in the early game, it's really important. Once you meet someone, you want to be able to maybe invade them, and when they have bad ground combat technology, you can overwhelm them. And it looks like this planet should be the next one to rush a starport. So I will stop applying the stimulus here. It will only take 8 turns, 5 more turns anyways. Now what about this one? It's relatively far. I think it doesn't need that many factories. This is also relative. So if I increase this, this one goes down, as you can see here, 50%. I don't know if it is visible well enough in the video, but I hope it is. Logistic range 1. Okay, this shall help me. Now this is a bit unfortunate, because I first would like to see what all got into the range before I decide whether I get nuclear engines or this one is... No, it is implemented actually. But it is for ship combat, and since I haven't met anyone, ship combat is not really that important. I think I will go for range 2. I probably wouldn't had I seen this before. Now I also have knowledge about a Baron system. I'll be building a new fighter over here, because I need this one in 2 turns to scout this planet, and it would take too long to scout it all with this one, and I will be seeing a lot more here. I'll be able to scout a lot more once this starport here finishes. This one has gone down in importance, because I now can reach these systems anyways due to getting the logistics technology, and I will be removing the ship production again. And which one first? This one, because it has better vision than the one in the nebula. It's really not that nice to start so close to nebula, especially... Well, I don't know where the others are, so if another faction would be here and they could attack me and I wouldn't get any information about that until it is too late. So I will probably be needing some missile bases to defend. And the starport is finished now, so I will be scouting all of these systems one after the other. Great. So, yeah, we're doing fine here. And here. And here we can also reduce the factory construction, as we have not enough population for all of that. And laser rifle was done, and now I'll be getting... these are both very useful technologies from the next tier. This one is very important because it halves the effectiveness of shields and is much more useful than the standard laser or also the Gatling laser, especially when the enemies decide to use shields on their ships. So I'll be getting the proton gun. The fusion bomb is also important because the standard bomb is not very strong and planets often have shields that it cannot penetrate for, except in the very early game. Another planet I cannot colonize, and another planet I cannot colonize. So I think I have two barons now. So once the research of improved ecological restoration is done, I could probably be getting baron colonization, or maybe the next tier, tundra colonization, if it's available. We'll see. Factory construction, very useful. And I'll be getting factory construction too, which reduces the cost by 19%. And two more uncolonizable planets. This one is the last. Radiated is the most difficult to colonize, and toxic the second most difficult. But at least this one has 30 population. So I'm now waiting for the starport over here to finish in order to colonize, to scout the system. I cannot colonize any more systems, which is according to the amount of systems I have scouted, being able to only colonize half of them is not that great. But if it wasn't like that, this starting location would be really good. It will become better. Here's another baron, so that's already three I will be getting relatively soon. And 90 factories. I will slowly build the starport here as well, just so I have more systems to send population from for further colonization or invasion of enemy worlds. But I'll build it with a low priority. 34 turns seems reasonable when it's done in 34 turns. Okay, here we have a system which is colonizable. I will send, yeah, I'll fill it to 50%, or maybe I should even get a bit higher and balance it out with this other system, because it's quite likely that I will want to build the starport over there, and then it's only good if I will also do this here. It's good when it's also kickstarted with a lot of population already. And we have a starport over here and can now scout this system. And I will stop the stimulus. Right now I will not add it to any other system. I will be getting some savings, and you get a small interest rate on this, which also can be increased by research, but not right now. Okay, now I can go for that colonization, but it's taking relatively long. It costs 884 RP, so I'll be settling for baron colonization first, because this would only allow me to colonize one more system, the tundra one, and I will be getting 3 for this little RP, and I will be getting this much earlier. And then I also want to get the 20% more population, not 20%, 20 more population technology from the second tier, because it's simply more useful to me than getting one more planet, this one, because 20 more on every planet is simply much better. Okay, I've colonized this one, but this is not the news I'm getting. So they finished all the factories and are now doing research. Okay, one system here, and this is a antimatter nebula, and it is impassable. So while this here is relatively dangerous because we cannot see what's going on here, this is really safe because no one can be coming from down here. It's like a if you compare it, it's like a wall basically, and I can't get there. I need to get a starport, and on this system it will be taking relatively long. I could also not build factories, but factories are really useful early on at least, so they pay for themselves relatively quickly when they are only a few. Factories get more and more expensive the more you already have, so the first few factories are cheaper, and when you have more, getting closer to your maximum, they'll be costing I think 20 or so for maximum and 10 for minimum, or I could be wrong. As you can see here, this is the waste. It was originally much higher, but now it's 24.7%, simply because we got a technology that reduces it. And I didn't show the before and after, but maybe someone had looked at it. And this looks colonizable yet again. Oh, it's an artifacts world. Artifacts means that the science production is doubled on this system. So there's two approaches to it. One thing is that I want to fill it up quicker. I don't want to wait for it to develop so long, so I will be getting the population to 90% right away. And I'll also reduce the factory production over here. And then I will also be boosting the system so it's done quicker with its factories and can start going full research mode earlier. Targeting system 2 was researched, and now we can get factory automation 3, which is really useful because it allows me, right now I can have twice the amount of factories as I have population, maximum population that is, but once I get this I can have 3 times the amount, so instead of 200 here on this my home planet it will be 300. And also the all factories will be operated then when I only lack a little population. Okay, barren colonization is done, and now I'll be getting terraforming plus 20%, and I'll be colonizing all of the barren systems. These are hostile, so population growth is halved on these. That's why I'm sending more population to them right away. And this one is rich. This is very good for ship production. And I'll be sending population from several systems. Let's get it to 90%. 88 is fine too. So this one I will colonize next turn, because all of my systems that have a starport, this one doesn't because I'm still building it. Now all of my systems with a starport are sending this turn. And shield and range was researched. So now the decision is a bit tougher. Planetary barriers really helpful against bombardment from enemies. But shield 4 is also quite useful. So I'm undecided which of the two, because shield 4 means basically it neutralizes all lasers, so if enemy only has lasers, I put on deflector shield 4, they cannot hurt me anymore. If they have proton gun, of course they can still hurt me, because it is halved in power, then it's like shield 2. And barrier shield 4. Well, this one helps my planets too, so those are added together. If you have a planetary shield and a deflector shield, your missile bases will have both shields added. Right now I have plus 2 deflector shield, and if I would could get this I would have 6 shield and for planets, and if I got this I would have 4 shield, unless I get this afterwards. I think I'm getting this. And I'm getting logistic range 3. Now this has not changed much. Not that many more words. But it means that I no longer need to finish the starport on Wolf. So I will stop boosting the system, because I can scout out this system right now. And I also need to colonize this one. Let's send a bit of this. Okay. Now this shall do. What else? Yeah, I can now also scout this system. And now actually this rose in importance. When you hover over there, you can see which colonies are receiving stimulus, and right now it's only Nixtux. It's useful so you don't forget which ones do that. But eventually we would like to have planets here, where you can see this in the overview, because right now we don't have that yet, but it would be really useful for later. And it also would be useful right now if it already was there. Okay, this is another relatively good planet. Not as good as this one, but if I build a starport over here, I would delay getting research. So I'm not sure if I shall do it, because I usually do not want to send population away from artifacts worlds. So I'm not going to build a starport on that one. I'm going to build it here. But I first have to colonize it, of course. Yeah, I'm a bit low on expandable population. Sending too much, I could speed up this much more. But all of these planets have full factories, and or at least enough factories to use. Right now I think I should have gotten automated factories. This was a computer technology as far, no, it was construction I think. But I haven't. I'll be getting it once I get this. Because a lot of the planets have more factories now than can be operated by population. But getting the factory, getting this one, factory automation will also help me a lot in this regard. So colonizing Laios has increased, so I'll be applying the stimulus here, and it makes no difference in the finishing time of the starport. We'll just add a little bit of research, so I better funnel it here for now, because this will also get me this system and another uncolonizable one. Yeah, I'll be using that one once it is doable next turn. Okay, now I can do it. Let's see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 colonies, which is really good for this stage of the game. But I have to say, the starting location really helped me with that. It was quite decent. And I also haven't met anyone yet, which also helps me. So I can... Okay, this was it about not having met anyone. Yeah, usually I would not show combat in such a puny fight. The thing is, these are, they have a slight advantage with their ship, so they have one attack and one defense bonus. and I would most likely lose. So taking this combat would be relatively pointless. If I auto-resolved, my covert would retreat. And this is also what I would do, so we'll save combat, showing combat for a real combat later on. Yeah, my covert retreated rightfully because it saw that. Yeah, and this one was one I couldn't see coming because of the stealth nebula here. And having the enemy exactly at the spot where I can't see anything, and also isolated through these planets, well, they will most likely not be able to colonize them anyways. There's only one faction that can colonize all systems right away, but they have a really hefty reduction of population growth to counterbalance this, so it's fair actually. Okay, now I want to get, and I would be getting one more star even here. Am I building starport here? No, I'm not. Which system elf am I also boosting? Laios. Okay, Laios will be done in 8 turns. So I'll finish that one first. It looks safer over here anyways. I think this could be the edge of the map, but I'm not sure of it. Because you don't have any indication where on the map you are, which is something I really like about this game. It makes the exploration phase more exciting when you do not know where your enemies are or where anything is. Okay, proton gun is researched. And this means I don't really need the mass drivers. Fusion bombs. Well, I don't know any of the enemy's planets. I will be getting Merculite missiles. They should be a great upgrade for my missile bases, which I don't have yet. But I will probably need to get some sooner or later to defend against enemy attacks. Another tundra planet, which I cannot colonize, but soon will be able to for more turns, and then I can scout the green one. And I will also later be using this system as main production system for ships, because it is rich and can churn out ships as a system that has twice the population. Okay, starport is done. I'll be reducing that and will be filling up with more factories. In this case, I actually want the factories all the way and not did it up with research, and I already had done this. I didn't even remember. I'm a bit tired. I don't know if you can tell, but now you can because I just said it. Logistic range 3. Okay, now there's no more range technologies researchable, but they're relatively good. This one is, by the way, not implemented, but I already know this by myself. 5 parsecs per turn, which is a great upgrade. And Wolf is done. I'm not really sure if I'll be doing the same as I did on this other system, slowly building a starport just so I have one, but I currently don't need it really for anything here. Here's no nearby system, but I can actually now, oh, I can send my fighter all the way over there. And they also will not see me coming because this system is also in the nebula. Are there any more planets? Yeah, what I guess that there's no, that this is the edge of the map here. Could be true because despite the further increase in range, didn't help in this regard. I think that once I got this speed technology that I'm currently researching in propulsion, I will change propulsion back to normal allocation. So what did I say? I wanted to get automated factories right. Yeah, I'm going to do this. And the system is ready. I don't know if I should start building ships. Currently, I mean, I have seen an enemy, I will not be sending the population from this planet, despite it is the nearest, but it is hostile and rich, which means hostile means basically that population growth is halved, so I will be sending population from a further system, and I might fill it up all the way, but I also might not. I think 50-65% is okay. I'll not be needing a starport over there anyways. So 9 more turns over here, and this one could also need a little bit more population, so I'm increasing it. I didn't send more population to the system because I didn't have more at the time, but now I do. Okay, factory automation. Now you can see I can actually tell all of my plants at once to spend a certain amount into factories. And since they are pretty expensive already, I say I'll be going to this 70% or so. It will not decrease it for planets that are below that. Okay, we have AI banking now, which increases the interest rate on my savings, which is actually quite nice. But then it's more useful to get some savings. Right now I'm investing it in starports, because that's probably more useful for me long term than some savings. And here we get terraforming 20%. I think 50% is sufficient, so because the population doesn't grow that fast. And we are already building more factories anyways, so I now can get Inferno colonization, which will add quite a few systems to be colonizable. Not that many, but I think it might be worth getting. I'm already getting quite a bit of research because I have quite a good amount of systems, and I'm curious to see what we'll find here. Okay, we have the first enemy system scouted. It has 45 population and 126 factories. I can bombard it. This is deathmatch mode, so we are at war with anyone anyways. And we can see an unknown fleet over here. Well, I'm pretty sure it belongs to the Xubgob. Okay, so I want to attack them. I could do an invasion. I have gotten 2 invasion technologies early, so I could just try to overwhelm them, and this is exactly what I'm going to try. So I will be sending from several planets at once. I can go into a bit of overpopulation because troops of mine will also die. Never this time I will be using the sync button, which means that they will be arriving at the same turn. This is simply done by delaying the sending from Seoul. So let me do it. And at the same time I want to be using ships. Destroyers always good to start with, but since I only have deflector 2 and not 4 yet, I'm debating whether to use the frigate instead. No, I'll be using the destroyer. I'll be putting on a few nuclear bombs and quite a few proton guns. I use, by the way, here you can see control increment 10 and shift 100. I pressed shift, so it was maxed out and I don't have to click for every single gun. So, and I will right now, since I'm not really sure, I will be only building on this planet over here. No research, but building ships, and we rally to our home system. I don't want to rally right away over there. The unfortunate thing is that I don't have a improved drive yet. I'm still researching it, which means these ships will be relatively slow. Yeah, and the production is also not that fast, because I also kind of want to build up this planet a little more. Yeah, the bombardment of the fighter does not much, because it's just a fighter, and fighters don't have any bombs, so they can just fire with a laser, and it's not killing anyone on the surface. And in one turn, I'll be able to scout all these systems. I might even... Yeah, can I use this one? Yes. That's very close, that it is still in range here. We can see the Corvette. Ah yeah, we can see it from here, because if we didn't have the systems, we wouldn't be able to see it, because the vision is blocked from here. And this one will be visiting those two systems. This one is not implemented. Yeah, battle suits, that's definitely useful. But it will be coming too late for my invasion of Niobe. But I probably have to try again. I don't know if my people can win, because I know that they start with a little bonus on everything. They are kind of the all-rounder faction. And another uncolonizable system over there. And it succeeded, actually. As I can already see, yeah, 17 out of 69 humans have survived, which is good. And we even captured a missile launcher, which is also good. And a few technologies, sublight drives, for example. Terraforming, well, we already have a better terraforming. AI banking, I think we were researching this right now, so we can now get a proton gun scanner. This will allow me to see them coming. Here they already have, well, it's only a Corvette, so it's not a big problem. The missile base that they erected for us will shoo them away. Currently no real need for more factories. Also not so much for terraform. I'll be sending more population over there. The one ship in orbit cannot do anything to my invaders. And I'll be upgrading my ship design here. I have to take out a few guns so I can put in a better engine. But it's okay for me. Better engine makes the ship much faster. I didn't change much about the coast. I will queue that it moves to Niobe right away and help defend over here. I really should be building a few scouts, actually. Actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, I don't need that many, but I'll be building some. Because... Okay, 2 Corvettes. Oh, I didn't... I just ordered because I knew that this fight was... that they were just going to retreat. Let's get another 2. 2 are enough, then I... Because I think that most likely those systems will be colonized. which means that my fighters might be destroyed and cannot continue scouting that, so that's why I'm building a few more. And actually, let's set the rally point right over there. Class 4 deflector shield. Okay, I'll be upgrading my ship design again, and I'll be getting the planetary barrier shield now. But first, I will colonize this system. This one is not yet colonizable, but I'm researching a technology that allows me to do it. And let me upgrade. Yeah, I'll need to remove even more guns. The firepower now is relatively decreased to what the first ship had, but it is much more durable against the enemy. So I'll change that again. And I'm considering building more ships on more systems, like my home system, for example. But I first want to get a bit more scouting information out of the enemy. Maybe they are already in trouble with someone else. Okay, factories has been finished here because this is a system which is rich, with richness also increases factory production. But since the system is hostile, terraforming takes them longer or is more costly, so to say. So this will take quite a while till this system is fully terraformed. Okay, here we have one missile base which only has nuclear missiles, and the shield is only level 2. And we have Vira with proton guns and nuclear bombs. Proton gun means that my level 4 shields are not that effective, and them not using shields means they have higher firepower, and it's actually a good design to counter my bigger ship, but it doesn't mean that my big ship is bad. I could replace the proton guns on my ship with lasers, which could be more cost efficient against ships that don't have shields. I will once again auto resolve the, no, actually I will take comment. So you can see the comment screen. The reason why I took this is that I wanna try and make sure that I can get away, but I'm not sure I can. First I will hide behind this asteroid so that the missile from the planet cannot hit me. But of course the ships will be closing in on mine. I think I can, I don't know if I'm not moving from here. The enemy ships might reach me, but when I'm moving, the missiles might hit me. I think I would try not to move. And they are still relatively slow, so it's only one more turn. And since the ship is small, it has a higher movement, so they are firing at the asteroid just in case. And now I can hit retreat, but 1, 2, 3, yeah, they can close in. I don't think my ship will survive this. Nope, it didn't. And this looks bad. I think this is the planet I captured from them, and now they're having a destroyer here with 22 proton guns, shield level 2, and 10 of these Vira ships. Well, I'll be taking this planet and I will be concentrating on the smaller ships with no shields because I'll be doing more damage to them. Let's see. This is the biggest stack. They are closing in, and the decision to send my ship all the way Yeah, I did 10 damage, which means half of the ships is. Half of one ship is done. And I have shield level 4, now one is dead. Their lasers don't really get through their shield and of the planet, because the planet halves all beam damage. And now they are taking an additional turn because they have a higher initiative than my planet. And I think I cannot hope for more than destroying one more ship, but even that is unlikely. Well, they have hit relatively badly. The damage of their Yeah, one more ship down. Maybe I can kill even more. Only one HP left. But they are not hitting. And now they hit with the laser actually. Which means they must have crit. Yeah, my missile base got destroyed here and they start bombing the system. And the problem was that it is still in this nebula where I couldn't see them coming, which I mentioned right at the beginning will be a problem. Yeah, we scouted this probe system, and this system is really terrible because it is ultra poor. Ultra poor systems are relatively useless. So while I invaded this, I will actually clear orders so this ship doesn't go right away to Niobe, and I will also set the rally point at Seoul, and I will be getting more ships here. Which one was the right one? Gilgamesh? Yeah, the one with shield 4. So maybe I also produce ships here. I need more ships, and I'm the faction that can afford having the most ships, so I shall make use of that. And I have quite a few systems, so I might be able to outproduce them. The other systems are not that good. These are the best production systems, my core systems here, the two first high population systems, and this one which is rich. I can do a little bit of factory production here. I'd say one per turn should be enough to keep up with the terraforming. It slows down the ship production, but I'll be getting more ships from the other two systems. And I don't think that I can defend this attack from them here. Yeah, they are bombarding the system down, and then they will most likely invade it. The good thing is that this is the only planet and I'm not really losing much. I even got a technology, and I just remembered that I wanted to, and now they are invading and have taken it back. And they've conquered two of my technologies, logistic range 3, which means basically they now can reach me. I could reach them with logistic range 3, and now they will be able to reach me. And since I'm currently researching these better missiles, right, but I will be going down here with the maneuver. Yeah, this is, so I'll be getting some more of the other technologies. And let me redesign the ship again. Fusion drives. I need to reduce the firepower even more. And I can only have a maximum amount of 6 designs. So I will be scrapping the projector. and change the production of all the... Wait a minute, didn't I? No, I didn't. Apparently I just reduced the research but increased, didn't increase for the chips, but now I did. And another Xugop word, Adrias. It's another ultra poor. So that's good for me. That means that they don't have that many good words, which makes it easier to compete with them. Another thing that will make it easier is that I'm on the edge more or less, and no one else can attack me. I'm safe from the bottom because of that. But I'm not safe at the top because I don't know what's here. And this system has been colonized and I want to get a starport. I'm also still boosting Everix. Where is this? Oh, it was this one. It doesn't need to boost anymore. Maybe I can lure some of their ships to the system. And what I'm searching here, proton gun scanner, yeah, this will help me see them earlier. But where's this Adrias? I think it's the other planet. And I don't think I'll be able to get away from here. Yeah, when there's frigate, I cannot get away. The artifacts world is done with terraforming. Yeah, they can definitely go into research mode now. I'll be getting technologies rather quickly from that one. Production's done, terraforming. Oh, let me get research here as well. Oh, it was this system actually. I thought it was this one. But they apparently have built a missile base on the ultra poor world to get rid of my ship and also send some frigates there. And here we have another frigate to retreat from. Oh, it was this system actually. The uncolonized one. I actually wonder why it's not colonized. Oh, this ship now will take a really long time because it is outside of my supply range, which means they cannot use warp drive. They have to use impulse drive, and this is really slow. It's half the speed of the slowest warp drive, which is actually less than that. Okay, they have now scouted my home system. I will try to cut them off. I think the AI would also have gotten this if I ordered the battle. They are trying to escape over there, and there's a bunch of asteroids which will make it harder to chase them. And I hope I can shoot them down. Yeah, I should be able to do it. Yeah, it was not a problem. So I killed their scouting ship. Wait, what is with yeah, the graphics, these hostile worlds, the larger hostile worlds, look so similar to the Terran ones, because they're also kind of blue. The Terran ones are also blue, so I thought that I had missed to colonize this, but it's a toxic world. Okay, already boosting the starport over here. Oh, 5 missile bases, 11 frigates and 1 destroyer. This is their home world. Yeah, there's no way I can get away. So they have at least 5 systems, but 2 of them are crap. So I don't know how many systems they actually have because, yeah, there's no scouting information over there. They could have more. They could be limited to it. I don't know. And they will not see me coming in when I attack Niobe. But with three destroyers, I feel it's still too risky. I will attack when I have five. This should at least enable me to retreat. And I will soon have five, I guess. Since I'm already producing. I could also produce more ships on Corellia, which is also a good world for production. But I kinda want to have more research worlds than production worlds. And since most of them are not fully developed yet, I'll leave it like it is. Actually, the problem is when I send all of them, they also include this one with only warp 2. This one has warp 4, and these have warp 5. So this would take 7 turns, and if I don't use it, it's 4 turns. And if I only use these, it's 3 turns. I guess I will send in the Gilgamesh, but I will leave the Vesuvius at home. Someone has to defend once. Maybe I should also be getting missile bases. The problem is without planetary shields, they are not really useful. I'm currently researching planetary shield, 3 turns, which actually means it's more because once it reaches the zero, it will be going up in percentage, and then it's a roll if you get it right away. So it's a bit of luck involved with getting technologies. Okay, the artifacts world is now ready with factories, which means I'll be getting quite a lot of research points, and I might be able to simply out-tech them while still building a lot of ships. So I'll be waiting for one more modern ship, because I don't want to send the Vesuvius with the others, simply for the reason that it is so slow and it's might possibly be quicker to get another ship. Yeah, I've gotten one. It was already being produced here. And the starport was finished. Be putting a bit in terraforming as well. And it's in completely different directions. This one will take too long. So what I'll do is build one. I could actually design a quicker one, but I'm too lazy to do this. Bigger fighter, but as I said, I don't really want to do this right now. I guess they can only, yeah, they can most likely only reach my home planet right now. I think getting one or two missile bases won't hurt. Actually, let's get three. Ever this year, I can set a limit, unlike in Mass of Orion, where you just had to remember where you issued building missile bases, and here you don't have to do that. You can set a limit and it will stop once this limit is reached. And next turn I will be arriving there. Let's see by what I am greeted by. Maybe they have their whole fleet there. And now I have Merculite missiles, which makes the decision to build the missile bases much more viable, because Merculite missiles are a lot better than the standard nuclear missiles. They also can penetrate enemy shields very well. And let's see, I think I'll be getting antimatter bombs, because I don't have a decent bombardment technology yet. And it's all in the same tier here. Which is great, I've unlocked 4 technologies in this tier. Okay, there's only one missile base and two frigates. And this missile base is really weak. So I will take comment, but I will press the auto button. Because I don't want to bother with managing such a simple fight. As you can see, the frigates are running away. They need to be at the edge to retreat, and they also need to be out of retreat cooldown. My ships are closing in. And maybe this is even too boring for you to watch. Oh, even my proton guns can get through the shield. They also don't have planetary shield. They have a better armor technology. I think I skipped it because I hadn't met anyone. But I'll be getting it once I get the next opportunity. So my ships will now go for the retreating ships. But I won't be getting them. They are almost gonna click resolve now. Don't want to watch the other retreat as well. Okay, let me bombard a little bit. I don't want to bombard that much to destroy all the factories, but since there's so little population compared to the factories, I can do this. And now I can invade this colony, and I think my faction bonus I don't think I will just confirm, so that those are, I'll get the plant a little quicker. My faction bonus is that I have really low maintenance costs, so I can afford quite a lot of ships and also do good research still, and I can basically outproduce the enemies. Now I've even gotten an improved armor, and my ground troops will be even more powerful, and I'll be getting sortium armor now, which will not only make the ground troops more powerful but allow me to design better ships as well. Come on, drop everything. I think I don't need to bump that much more population. It's a bit hard decision. You want to keep as many factories so you don't have to rebuild the factories, but you also don't want to lose that much population. But since my population has three good ground combat technologies, maybe a lot of them will survive anyways. Yeah, I've not forgotten to disable the production of the ships over there. I could already be sending more ships, but the enemy could theoretically have been sending ships towards me, but it's this one increases my tax income. I kind of want to have it. I kind of want to have it too, and I also want to have that. There's too many useful technologies, but I think soil enrichment is the most useful one. And they are attacking Niobe with one destroyer and 27 frigates. Now this could be an exciting battle. My population has not arrived yet, right? Let's see, this one has shields 4. I'll be advancing slowly. Because I kind of want to get them in firing range first and then counter them. They have proton guns, so they are not a pushover. Yeah, there's at the edge of the range, which is good, which means I can close in. and do a lot of damage to these ships. Yeah, we destroyed already quite a bunch of them. And they are trying to get away now. And once they destroyed my ship anyways, they stopped trying to get away. Oh, this was good. This was a crit. Yeah, when you attack from directly behind, your chances of critting are higher. Yeah, I think they will still again try to retreat. I should take care that I do not chase with the damaged one, because I don't want to lose it. Ooh, shit! Now they killed it. I could easily have prevented that by not chasing with it. But as I said before, I'm kinda tired and I didn't pay too much attention. Now they are out of range here. But I'll be getting some more shots on them. No, actually not. They move again before I can, because those smaller ships can move a little bit more, and now I'm not getting into range. Nope, I also will not be getting into range for this, so I will just click resolve. And I have won the battle, but I've lost two ships, and I'm dropping all, because it could be that they send another attack which I cannot hold. And here we have another artifacts word, which we send a lot of population to. 40 troops have landed on Niobe. Good. And we got Duraloy armor, which is better than the one we have. Yeah, everything is up to date. But we can add more guns. And change the production to this new ship. I think I'll be sending everyone. I don't think that they were sending anything to Seoul, and now they cannot even reach it anymore. And once, if they should attack again, I want my ships to be there. And I got barrier. I will not build this on all systems. No, I won't. And two frigates. Nah. I will just order it. And oh, a 113 fertile planet. This needs to be colonized immediately. Okay, 50% is enough. It's fertile, it will grow fast enough. I think my starting location really was good in this game, and it might make for a longer let's play in this regard. But I'm saying I will not be doing that much more in this episode, maybe a little bit. I mean, episode, it's quite long, I guess. Most likely over an hour. Proton gun scanner. If my planet was not in the nebula, I would be able to see a lot of them now. Factory automation 4. I don't think all of the planets have the level 3 yet. And it's also quite expensive, so, but my targeting system is only level 2. Which means targeting system 5 will be getting 15% more chance to hit, and base is not 100. So, the increase in attack power for my ships is quite significant for getting this. So I'll be skipping the factory automation 4 for now. I might get it as the technology afterwards, because I generally don't really research the ECMs. Unless sometimes later they are not that useful, unless you run into a large amount of missile bases, which the AI usually does not have. They only build a few. Well, actually on Zugobia they were 5 missile bases, but the missiles are so crappy that it's not worth it. Maybe once they get a better missile tech. And actually, we have a better missile tech. So we will want to rush at least one missile base and shields and apply the stimulus. We have saved up quite a lot. So we will hopefully be able to hold this planet this time. And once we established it with the shield and some of the now much better missile bases, it should be a good base for colonizing more. And this new system I will be also getting. Nah, I will not be getting shields on Sol, because right now Sol is unreachable for them. Lazitus. Yeah, I need to get a starport here. Because there's two more systems I cannot reach yet, which I'd like to be able to reach. Missile base is done, now shield will be done in 3 more turns, and then I will switch this off again. Wolf has built the starport. Yeah, this was the system where I was building the starport really slow. And I'm pretty sure I will be holding this planet right now. So I will be changing the relocation. By the way, to get this, get all existing ones to one system, you press Alt R. I can show again here. Alt R. Alt R. And they are attacking again. But I didn't know that I already have a missile base now. I suppose they, yeah, it doesn't look like they want to stay and fight. They are spreading out, so I cannot take all of them with me, but I will try to kill a few of them. Let's see, those will be hiding. Maybe I can hit this one, and I have Mercury Light missiles now. Okay, it hides behind the rocks, so it doesn't get hit by the missile. Then I will be attacking those. Yeah, this was probably an error to go so far away from the edge. Do I chase this one, or do I try to destroy as many of the small ones? Maybe both? Oh, damn it, it's still alive. This might have been a mistake. Could have done a little more damage. And now they are all retreating. Okay, didn't get the destroyer, but I got 5 of the frigates, which is also good enough for me right now. Okay, I need a starport here. Don't really know if I should boost it. Yeah, I can afford it, I guess, since I have quite a saving. And it's also quite likely that those two systems will be relatively safe. I have to say I'm doing really well right now, which mostly is according to this starting location, where it took quite a while to run into an enemy. And it looked pretty safe to begin with, and I also want to get some terraforming done here and remove the stimulus now, since I have the missile base and the maybe I can get some more. Let's get up to 3. They don't need to rush it anymore because the shield is up now, and this plant will be, at least not with the ships they already have. They only have the nuclear bombs, and this they do a maximum of 12 damage. And the shield now is level 8, which means even if they roll a high amount of damage, they will not be doing more than 4 damage. And this is the maximum, and so it's very unlikely they will even get that high. Yeah, I think I should be attacking the next system. I don't want the ultra poor one. Yeah, let's go for Probus. Could probably have done it a little earlier. 255 factories. Don't know if they see me already or how long I was hidden by the nebula. But I don't see any ships here. And I already have the better scanners, I think. Yeah, proton gun scanner level. Oh, for some reason I have AI thinking twice. This shouldn't be it shouldn't be possible. I captured it and I probably also researched it. So this is a bug. Okay, 2 missile bases, 3 frigates. The missile base is still on only. I think I can just auto this. There's no need to watch. Population is relatively low. And now it's even lower. This planet just finished the factories. And I can now invade here. This time I will use sync, so they arrive in 4 turns. I don't know if I should bomb more or not. Soil enrichment is done. Yeah, this is so useful. I'll be building it full speed on all systems because it increases population growth speed. Cloning also does this, by the way. Yeah, I want to increase the taxes from population now. Oh, the starport over here is already done. This was quick. Are we doing terraforming? And scout those two systems. What is with this one? It's still building. How many stimulus? Oh, it's only the system. Let's reduce the population just a little bit more. Okay, it's only 4 population left. So this will be really easy to conquer. Hostile system is done with building factories. It's still terraforming. I never set it to do some research, but it doesn't matter. Since I am not going to lose this system, it was just invested in the future. Oh, I have something running in the background. I think a stream that now works again. I've been hearing these noises, and you probably also hear them. It's a boudoir AI stream, and I will. I think I will just invade this system, and then I will end this part and maybe look at this now once again working stream. Okay, no bombardment this turn. Don't want full factory building on these systems that already have so many. 50% should be enough. Here we can build 100%, and we actually should get some terraforming as well, since the system is full. You might actually continue to apply the stimulus, since this is an artifacts world and I want to be using it to its full potential for researching. So I want to get it up to its full potential first. Okay, one more turn, and then my invasion will be completed. Oh, a fertile world with 157 population, but it is ultra poor. Well, I just send a little population to this. It can grow from by its own. It's not really worth to invest too much into ultra poor. And I think having those two ultra poor worlds is also hurting this AI here quite a bit. Since those planets are really terrible to get useful. So I'll be doing everything here. And I will defend it with my ships before the missile bases are done. And active sensors. Yeah, there's not much left to steal from them. Only get one technology despite conquering quite a lot of factories. This means they are close to be finished. There's two frigates. Maybe they're going to this system. Oh, I could have colonized it. I think there's quite a few systems I could have colonized. And I didn't realize it. I probably have this technology since quite some time. Yeah, this is something I need to do now, because if I don't, I will forget it when I continue this game. Oh, so it does not have excess population. This one is. I first want to scout this system. Let me send this one to Yorktown. There might be a colony since they are sending frigates there. I don't know. use none, I can see that. Predestination is another system I can send to. Let me send a bit more and more. Okay, that's enough. Lapazy, okay. Fascia. I'll be sending one Yorktown over there. Oh, there's actually two unscouted systems. So I'll do it like this. And yeah, that's it. I will continue this game later. And for now, yeah, it's been going really well. It's not that often that you can get so many colonies so easily. But I succeeded in doing so. But as I said, I will wrap it up here and continue sometime later. Not in the next few days, because I won't be here. But I don't know how big the video is. Maybe I can't even upload it. I will have to upload it the whole night, because it probably is really big. So, goodbye.